Orlando's fire chief confirms to WESH 2 they are now investigating a high-ranking fire official who had his gun stolen from a city-issued vehicle. While District Chief David Harris owns the handgun legally, officials say he is not authorized to have that weapon in a city-owned vehicle. WESH 2's Bob Keeling live outside the fire station, and Fire Station 1, that is. And Bob, Chief Harris reportedly attributed his need to carry a gun to recent events in Newtown, Connecticut.
Well, that's right. And the fire chief, John Miller, says that Harris told him he has young children about that same age and felt the need to carry a gun. So yesterday, according to the Orlando Police Department, Harris's marked fire station vehicle was parked inside this parking garage when someone let themselves into the car and stole it. Orlando Fire Department District Chief Dave Harris's Facebook page shows him with his three children, ages 8 years of age and younger. In light of the Connecticut school massacre on Friday, Harris told his chief that he felt he needed to carry a weapon in his city-issued vehicle to keep his children safe.
Some of the early indication was as a concern related to Newtown and some of the things that happened here in the last few days.
While Harris was working between 9 and 5 yesterday, Orlando police records indicate someone opened Harris's unlocked car parked in this garage across from Station 1 and stole Harris's personal .380 Ruger handgun like this one and a digital camera. Harris owns the gun legally, but
he is not one of the ones that is authorized to carry a weapon on duty.
So on its face, this does appear to be a violation of city policy.
Clearly, it appears so if he had it in his vehicle.
Is it discouraging to you to know that there is someone who's in charge of public safety and yet leaving a gun in a car where it's stolen and now could be used against someone else?
Yeah, Bob, like I said, we take this very seriously.
Miller says this is the first time in the Orlando Fire Department's history that someone has been suspected of this type of violation.
He's a well-respected officer within the organization. If he has made this mistake, he will be held accountable for it, but it is extremely isolated.
But not completely unprecedented in the city of Orlando. You may remember in April of 2009, it was the city of Orlando's police chief at the time, Val Demings, who had her handgun stolen out of her SUV in front of her residence. And as a result, her own department issued her a written censure. As for the investigation into this case, it's just beginning. And the chief says for now, Harris' status remains unchanged until there is some resolution. Reporting live outside Station 1 in downtown Orlando, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.